We have to think about what kinds of values are we going to be rewarding? What are the values that we care to reward? What do we mean by collaboration? Mm-hmm. Collaboration typically is what we think as a, when we think about somebody as being collaborative, we associate it with more of a woman's attribute. But in fact, it's everybody's attribute. How do we create a world that's you know, more humanistic? And that's becoming more and more of a topic.
Now, do you feel that that idea would have universal appeal? Because in many cultures, ruthless competition is the order of the day. It's not based on empathy. You want to arise at the top of the heap with everybody below you.
Mm-hmm.
Can you convince people that that's wrong and that they ought to change?
I think I think part of it is actually having the dialogues that we're having today, right? It's, you know, in terms of having the workshops, having recognition that this is probably a topic that we need to think about having. Yes, there's competition. Ruthless competition, just by definition, is ruthless, right? And so there are people who just fall off the cliff, and they're not always women. There are also men involved in that falling off the cliff. The ruthlessness of the environment are no longer nurturing. And you see, nurturing, collaboration, and people will argue, is that really what we should be having? I will point out that of the 17 Sustainable Development Goals that have come out of the United Nations this past September, number 5 is this notion of gender equality. And so you have number 1, which is eradicate poverty, but number 5 is gender equality. And so it is obvious an issue of countries, which makes it an issue of companies, it makes it an issue of society as a whole.
Can this be imposed top-down, such an important cultural change, or does it have to be widely accepted at the bottom level?
It has to be, in my argument, it has to be widely acceptable at the bottom, but all in addition to the top, so at the bottom level too. Culture is the most difficult part of any organization to change. Mandating it is, you know, for what I will call a force function is not probably what you want to see. It should be part of a DNA of an organism. It should be part of the DNA of an enterprise. It should be part of the DNA of who we are. There are studies out there that suggest that it's good business to have diverse sets of minds. In fact, it increases the collective intelligence of a group.
We're basically talking about women have a lot to contribute because they have a lot of productive capacity, which isn't always being tapped, and we should release that productive capacity and, you know, put it to use.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that's a very nice way of putting it. I mean, there is an intense interest to do great things and to do great things together.